my initial start was I didn't actually want to run track at first. I wanted to play football. So I literally was that girl that ran routes and caught the ball, threw the ball, kicked the ball. And my mom was like, no daughter of mine is going to play football. So my dad said, what about track? Her brother's running track. That's a good look. And she threw me out there, and I was faster than most guys my age. I was about 4 or 5. So then she was like, I think track's probably where she's going to stay. So I developed my love for track just on the basis of me doing it by myself, for myself, with myself.
So what would make someone want to do the heptathlon?
I had never trained for it. They put me in it, and lo and behold, I qualified for nationals in the multi my first year doing it. So granted, I still didn't know how to hurdle. I was completely oblivious to everything.
Right.
And it ultimately made me want to learn more about it, because not a lot of girls want to do it. It's like some people have their one respective thing or their two respective things, and that's it. But then when you really look at a multi, you say, oh, she can do this, 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 and this. She can run, she can jump, she can throw. What else can she do? That's when you get people who can do 400 hurdles who typically don't, or people who can run a 1500 who typically just stop at the 8. So it honestly helped me become a stronger athlete and a stronger individual as a person.
Watch the time take care of itself. Don't worry about the time. You just execute the phases in the race and watch the time handle itself.
Man, number one, I mean, you have to have a strong mental capacity. I mean, this sport is 85% mental. I mean, it's big time mental. You know, when you step on the line and you hear on your mark, or you hear that bell lap ring, I mean, literally, your mind starts racing. So number one, you have to have a strong mental capacity. If you don't have that, you won't survive. And she definitely has that. You know, I just tell her what I expect of her, and literally it's like she goes in her own sanctuary and she says, okay, this is what coach expects, this is what I need to get done. So number one, she has it mentally. Two, she's physically strong. She's one of the strongest girls on our team. She's not that big, but she's very, very strong. She's our strongest power cleaner. She's our strongest squat. And so, you know, she has the strength, you know. And so when you have that, you combine mental capacity with strength, and then she has really good speed.
My dad is a coach. My dad as a coach can be frustrating, because sometimes I want him to be that dad on the track instead of Coach Banks 24/7, and it can be frustrating, and sometimes myself or my mom have to reel him back in and say, hey, don't forget, you're a coach, but you know, she's your daughter too. So it's like, just making sure that I have that dividing line is great. But having him as a coach from when I was about 4 or 5 to even in high school, it was a great experience, because it was like we bonded and we connected on a level that most daughters and fathers don't exactly connect. It was a great experience.
I want her to do extremely well in school. I want her to be top academically, first and foremost. Secondly, I want her to enjoy what she's doing. I want her to enjoy being an athlete, just really seize these moments.
If you're going to get faster like that, let me
But my main component for every single thing is to be steady, to be relaxed, to kind of take a deep breath, be like, you know what, you got this. It's not like you've never done this before. And my grandmother used to say, you know, you're a Banks, you can handle it. My dad says, act like you've been there before. Same show, different time. So just keeping that in mind and making sure that I, for one, stay focused and stay in that mind frame of I can do it.